I'm asking.
That's crazy.
Good morning, guys. Adrian Unknown. I'm out here with Muddy River Catfishing's Chris Flores. We're about to put a herding on some catfish. We're in about 11 feet of water here at this place called Caballo Lake State Park. I'm not sure if it's a lake or a reservoir, one or the other, it doesn't matter. It's got water in it. Got the big brushy mountains out there. What are these things, these bags?
It's basically like a parachute for the boat. So what's happening is the wind is pushing us across the top of the surface of the water, right?
Yeah.
And that will scoop the water and slow us down a little bit.
So, oh.
So it'll keep us moving at a slower speed.
Gotcha. Cool. So yeah, guys, from what I learned, these little hump looking things on the screen, those are fish themselves, right? The U's?
Yes, sir.
Those are bends. So would this big U be a big fish?
That's, yeah, the bigger the mark, the bigger the fish.
Let's try to catch these big fish. I'm gonna have to get a new GoPro hat soon. This one on the back is getting a little bit loosed. Yeah. How long have you had this pontoon boat for?
I think like 6 years, bro.
Is it a pontoon or a tritoon?
It's actually a deck boat. It looks like a pontoon from the top.
Yeah.
But it's fiberglass hull on the bottom.
Oh, okay. So. What are we using here? Carp?
Carp. Just the other day when you guys were out there.
Awesome. Yeah. Some big chunky pieces, about 2-3 inches. The bigger the bait, the bigger the fish, guys. Any particular hook you like using?
I use Daiichi's. Daiichi circle hooks.
Circle hooks?
5-0 and their 7-0 is more like an 8-0. I like that.
You haven't had somebody to sponsor and make your own hooks yet, Muddy River?
For a while, man, and then we kind of went our separate ways.
I see those Minotaur hooks are doing really good right now on Facebook.
Yeah.
People are jumping on those.
Yeah.
So yeah, this is the Catfish Lake, guys, here in southern New Mexico. We're just down the street from Elephant Butte. Elephant Butte's up that way. If you were to go up toward all that greenery over there, that's where one of the shallow rivers is, a place called Seco. It's where a lot of big fish are caught. Keep going up that way and then you'll eventually get to the Elephant. You like to use a mix of threaded and mono?
So what I'll do is I'll do braid as my main line.
Yeah.
And then I'll do the mono as my leader.
For abrasion?
For abrasion and I use a smaller test. That way if my line breaks, it breaks down here somewhere and I don't lose my whole rig.
Gotcha.
So we're gonna drag baits today for now.
Okay.
We got this little breeze going.
Tell me a little bit about your rig that you got going on here.
So they call this a high-low rig, but the idea is for you've got to bait at different elevations or levels in the water, right?
Gotcha.
The thing that I do is I add this float and it's trapped with the swivel so that it's a true high-low rig. That way if there's any slack, it's still floating.
Gotcha, so it's always standing straight up off the ground.
Without the float, it could just lay on the ground and you
got to move
on the ground and there's really no point in having the high-low rig, right? So that's what I use. I use it both for dragon baits and for anchor.
So I noticed that you're not fishing directly in the bottom. The catfish are elevated off the ground a little bit there.
One of the things I like to do is I like to get my baits off the bottom. It makes it easier for the fish to to access it, you know. If it's dragging straight in the mud, they might not find it as easily. And also, if you're fishing in current and you're fishing on the bottom, the current could push that bait underneath stuff.
Yeah.
And the fish